Los Angeles, California. It's Landed Late Night. Tonight's guest,
Jules Aurora.
And now, your host, Haley.
She's like pretty much a Disney princess in real life. She's a real life princess? Oh my god! We have royalty in the house tonight, you guys! Okay. She has the most amazing voice on the planet. I'm gonna make her sing a little bit on the show tonight. She's like, no, please don't. I'm kidding. Please, please, please give a warm late night welcome to Jules Aurora! Thank you so much for having me. Oh my gosh, thanks for coming on, Mama. Seriously, we gotta go out again with all the girls. And
yes.
That time, you know, I'm gonna make you drink next time, though.
Yeah, last time I didn't.
You know what? We're all lightweights, but it's like,
yeah.
We have to pay less money, which is like, but this time I brought her three drinks. It's all straight vodka. No, I'm kidding. It's not. Don't worry. It's only vodka.
See, I turn red. It's because I have a tomato face. When I drink alcohol, I'll smell alcohol and I'll be like, oh, I'm buzzed. You know, it's that bad.
See?
I'm buzzed.
I'm so drunk right now. I tell myself that vodka waters are like the same thing. You know what I mean? I'm dehydrating while I'm hydrating.
Essentially.
Then it's just, it becomes neutral. Totally. And it's fine. Everything's good to go.
Yes.
Oh my gosh. Thank you. I'm like, how have you been? You know?
It's been
like a month since I've seen you.
I know. I met you at the...
At Christina's birthday
party. Christina's birthday party.
Yeah. I have been like obsessed with you ever since I met you.
Aww.
And you're so talented. You really are.
Thank
and all
you.
Your videos. And so... You got your start doing, she's a singer-songwriter, incredible musician, artist.
I saw you were at Coachella playing on the piano.
Yeah, that was actually, that video, I posted that like 2 years ago.
Oh.
And it got like 9 million views the first time I posted it, which is crazy. Randomly, there was a piano in the middle of like the whole park. But everything means nothing. People were like flocking from like all over, running to you. Like, what is this voice? Who is this person? No, you're so talented, and you like. I mean, you do a lot of Broadway stuff, right?
Yeah, I'm actually in Mamma Mia right now.
Yes, you are.
That's so exciting.
Yeah.
Exactly.
I can't sing next.
Yeah,
to you.
And we have the whole disco pants. It's gonna be fun. But
yeah, because you've been in like crazy rehearsals, and your schedule's been insane.
Yeah, it's been crazy. We've been rehearsing every day because we only have 3 weeks to put the show up.
Oh my god.
So it's been every day from
normal?
6 to 11, and then weekends. No, normally it's a little bit longer, but
that
this
seems like really
yeah,
short.
This is just bam, 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 like. And we're learning dances, and it's
oh
crazy.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, but
how did you book that role?
Actually,
what was the whole process like?
It was... I've been auditioning for theater stuff mm-hmm. more recently. Like, I started in musical theater.
Okay.
So I did, like, musicals in high school
okay.
and in college. And I did a lot of covers
yep.
of Disney things and just other musicals that I love. I love Lea Salonga.
And Jasmine.
I actually auditioned. One of my dream roles is Princess Jasmine, so hopefully. I'm putting it into the universe.
Yes, girl. That is a real thing.
It really
is. We put it out there, and we take it in.
It really is. So, yeah, I started singing that way, and then I sang with the jazz band for a little bit. I was basically traveling around with Royal Caribbean.
Okay.
I did.
I saw that for, like, 8 months, right?
Yeah. So musical theater for that whole contract, and then I came back to L.A., and I've been writing a lot more, doing the pop stuff, pop R&B, because I also have a... love for pop and R&B, so it's
yeah.
weird. Like, I just love everything. I just love singing and performing.
So. Yeah, I mean, you are so hot, like, on camera. I was just going through, like, all of your videos, and she's like... It's gone as I'm craving the feeling. That was
your, like, elevated video.
You sing in a tub.
Yeah,
yeah. And I was like living for it because honestly, like
yeah.
you're so in person, which everyone can see. You're just so bubbly and sweet and kind of like little. And then she's like this like little sex kitten and like
you
all
know,
these.
Yeah,
I love it.
Just the one video.
There's only
one video where
no,
I'm sexy.
But you like it's like a subtle like sexiness in everything that you do. Even like
thank you.
There was a picture you posted. I just liked today. It was when your crush walks by and your friends are like, "Be chill, be chill," and you're like, "What?"
Yeah, because, okay, all my friends
so
know
hot.
That I'm just very extra.
Yeah.
Because why not be extra?
You know?
Thank you.
Exactly.
Finally.
And so, yeah, so whenever I'm on the
you know, in my zone.
Yeah.
I'm just doing all the hair flips and everything. Because yeah. why not?
Exactly.
But yeah, also I did that video, that one sexy video, yeah. because I wanted something that was a little bit spicier than normal.
Yeah, so spicy.
Yeah, my fans Ooh. Didn't know what to do. They were like, what spicy is this?
Marg.
Like,
who That's is what this? I call you. Well, spicy marg. little spicy marg.
Sweet, a little spicy. Yeah. Depending on the day.
Yeah.
I have a lot of different sides to me. Sometimes I'm a Disney princess. Sometimes I feel like I want to be Beyonce, so...
Hey.
You know, like the Filipino version.
Yes, the prettier version.
No!
You're so...
Beyonce is the queen.
She Her is. Live I know, I'm sorry, Beyonce. I love you. Yeah, oh and my god, it did.
I was in the car, I was like, I'm a diva.
Yeah.
I was like, There's and the person next to me was like, what is she doing?
Yeah, you're like, you just wish you had moves like this. No, there's yeah. a scene, one of my friends posted a Snapchat, and it was like, suck on my balls, but they're like dancing, they're dancing with their, like, they look so hot,
yeah.
but what they're saying is so funny, and I'm like, if they had just taken out, like, the costumes and the theatrics and the dance moves, and we're just saying that, it would be so weird. But because it's Beyonce, and because
Beyonce
she can literally
whatever.
Say whatever she wants to say,
yeah,
it's flawless. You know what
it
I mean?
Is. It is.
I mean, yeah she's queen anyways. Yeah. Enough about Beyonce, more about you, because you're going to be the next Beyonce. Beyonce, I'm going to be it. I keep breaking the fourth wall. Stop it. Okay, so you were on a cruise ship for like 8 months.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of want to actually ask, what was that like?
It was honestly, okay, so I don't think I would do it again
okay.
because it was a lot to take in. Like, your cabin is probably... It's just so tiny. It's yeah. just tiny. And I'm a small human, but still, it's small for me. Yeah.
Well, and you're landlocked. I mean, not landlocked. Wait, yeah. You're landlocked on a boat
yeah.
for 8 months.
Well, basically, like, you can get off at all the ports.
Oh, yeah.
And
true.
So we would have overnights in Nassau, Bahamas. And
oh.
there was one night I was singing, I want to dance with somebody. And I was, like, in the middle of the rain, just dancing.
Wow.
In the Bahamas.
Wow.
So those experiences
yeah.
were amazing. I broke my glasses that night because I was...
Okay, this is what I'm saying. Like, we need to go out again because you're just telling all these stories, and I'm like, cool, I haven't gotten to see the side of you, so we need to go out and freaking
Yeah,
dance.
I have my moments. They're rare, but
I'm going to get a lot of them out of you then. That's my new goal is to take you out and make it.
Yeah, it'll be a challenge, but yeah, but it was a really good experience.
Yeah.
And then musically, I was performing for 1,000 people every other night, basically. And so they have a lead female and then a lead male, so I was...
Okay.
We did a lot of musical stuff from West Side Story, from Little Shop of Horrors, from Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
And we were, you know, the Cell Block Tango.
Yes. No, I do know what that is.
Yeah.
Yes.
So it was
And I'm thinking
super fun.
Little Shop... I don't know why I know this song. It's like, Little Shop of Horrors.
Yeah. I was one of the girls in the... It was like, Little Shop of Horrors, Little Shop.
I love that.
Yeah, with the whole dance.
I think maybe I should... I'm quitting my job. I'm going to go on Broadway.
You should.
I can't sing like that well like you can, but I just love the... I love performing. And
yeah.
like, Broadway is so... Like,
it's
grand.
So big because, like, TV and film acting
yeah.
is just right here.
Yes, yes.
And then Broadway is like, I'm so sad.
Yeah,
you know.
I know. Whenever I've taken like improv classes, and I've only taken one acting class, but we would have every time we'd have people that were like used to doing Broadway
yeah.
or like just theater, and every time the coach would be like, literally, calm it down. You're like here. I need you like 10 notches
yeah.
lower. But they're so used to like doing over the top. And
yeah.
I remember thinking like, this isn't any. Like, I want to, like, but that's why I liked improv, because improv you can just be, like, crazy, but yeah.
Theater is just, it's big, and you wear sequins and fun costumes, and
yeah.
the whole contract was just me learning how to be bigger on stage and
yeah.
being comfortable, because I got super comfortable singing for thousands of people
yeah.
all the time.
Which
and
is,
then,
like, such good experience, because
yeah.
now it, like, build your confidence, I'm sure, so much.
So much.
Yeah.
So much. And then, actually, I didn't even have a following. Probably, like, when I went on the ship, I had less than 10,000 or
yeah.
5,000. It was just small. And then, because I was on the ship, I was doing covers all the time during my free time. I was working on my voice, working on everything, and then I started doing covers when I came back,
mm-hmm.
and that's when I started putting out all my videos, so all of that built my following after that. So it all came together.
Yeah.
Real good.
And that was how long, like, what was that time frame like?
I was on the ship for 8 months, and then I started doing a YouTube video every week
okay.
for that whole first part of the time when I was back.
Yeah, see, that's what's hard, is, like, I'm just now getting into the YouTube game, and I'm like, everyone's like, you have to be releasing at least once a week, and you have to be doing, like, consistently
yeah.
and all this stuff. And it's hard. It's like, if you have other
it's
jobs,
so
it's like,
It's very yeah. It doesn't sound like it's a lot, mm-hmm. but it is. And then if you're making, were you shooting every week?
Yeah, I was shooting every week. And then it was, or some days I would do 3 covers in one day.
Yeah,
and
yeah, I'm just like shooting bulk.
Yeah, yeah. But I need to get back on the YouTube thing too, because I also do Instagram covers, which yes. is shorter.
Yeah.
But yeah, I've been focusing more on original stuff lately, but to build everything that I've built, it was through covers.
Yeah. And then you put an EP out. Tell us about that.
I did. I have an EP out called The Silver Lining that actually came out last year.
Yeah.
And then that one's mainly pop, mm-hmm. but this new one that I'm working on is all R&B, and I've released 3 songs from it. So Elevated, Company, and Letting You Go, which is the most recent one. Yeah. So all of that's more R&B, and then that's coming out probably summer, that
and
project.
R&B, I love it. So it's going to be more sexy?
Yeah.
A little more spicy.
Sexy, a little more soulful.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, if you need photos, you know.
Yes, girl. Yes, of course.
We'll get, like, you popping. We'll get your aesthetic all right.
Of course.
I'm so serious.
I'm so down.
It's so fun, like, shooting with friends, too, because you just hype each other up, and you're just like, oh, yes, girl, like, yeah. work the
no,
hair.
No, we did that in the bathroom already, remember?
Oh, no, that's true. Yeah. I honestly, like, I was shooting this whole week in Coachella, like, just being around girlfriends, all we did was just shoot photos of each other, mm-hmm. and, which sounds so stupid, but it was so fun, because, like, every, you know, you're channeling, you're on all the people that you're comfortable with.
Yeah.
And, like, Christina's like this, too. Yeah. She's like, you know, so like, okay, yeah. work it, mad at everybody.
I think that's every girl. And then I know. You make the, you take like 20 pictures, my whole camera roll. Sometimes when I, like when I'm dating people,
yes.
they're like, why do you have so many pictures? I'm just like, you don't understand.
Yeah.
You're not a girl.
Yeah.
Every girl has 30 of the same selfie yes. and you have to narrow it
and
down.
And there's like the slightest movement can like make or break a photo. Okay. I know I'm like lighting. I'm like, which one's better? Like this way? This way. Give me that selfie light.
Yeah,
honestly, these LEDs, though, like, I'm sorry, LEDs, you should make them sound, like, bougie or nicer. They're from Amazon, guys, straight up. They're not bougie. I know, I wish you could just have, like, a compound of, like, all the girls who, like, do creative stuff and just, we just, like, all frolic around and hang out.
I think women need to stick together more in general.
Yes, well, yes. We should talk about that.
Yeah.
I love, like, I say this a lot on the show, and I've talked about this, you know, just with all my friends, but community is everything, and having girlfriends, like solid girlfriends,
yeah.
is a game changer. Like, if your girlfriends are not hyping you the F up when you're taking a selfie or pictures, they gotta go. Like,
and it's so true, though. It's so true because I think girls are actually stronger. You're so much stronger when you have a tribe around you and people motivating you. And I think a lot of the times girls are taught to be competing with each other.
Right.
When really, mm-hmm. it's just so much better, and you move forward faster when you stick together. It's like your talents, oh, I could help you do this, or I could, and I think that's why it's so important to collaborate, especially with other artists that are striving for dreams that are in the same field.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
I feel like everyone, you don't get anywhere doing anything alone. Mm-hmm. Like, no one's self-made. That's not a thing. Like, even people that say they are, one, they're like narcissistic, but two, they always have a team of people around them helping them out. Like, you can't do anything alone. Mm-hmm. And if you can, it only lasts for like, it's like very short lived, mm-hmm. and then you burn out. And so that's why it's important to have really solid friends. And like, just thankful that I do, and thankful that I met you. You're so sweet.
Thank you, Haley.
Thank you. Okay, so tell me about your dating life.
Oh my goodness. My dating life is very complicated.
Well, she's really private about it, and I love that. I do. We were talking earlier about like how you're either like trying to be couple goals on Instagram or you're just private about it.
Yeah, because it's very difficult because now everything's your brand on Instagram or on social media. And it's crazy because like I would consider myself starting out. I would say that I'm still building to get to where I want to be, which is also another thing on social media. It's like people think that, oh, she's made it. Like, no, we're all still grinding and we're all still doing things and have big goals. And right now it's just like I want the main focus to be music. Mm-hmm. So I try to keep everything kind of focused on that. Like, in my stories, sometimes I'll put, like, little personal things, but, yeah, I don't know. My love life, I've never really been that open with it in public.
Yeah.
But, I mean,
and that's not, like,
I also have a love affair with pizza, so that I'll say.
That's a relationship in itself. Okay. Mine is a love-hate. I love it. It hates me, but, you know, you can't win them all. I love that. I think it's different. I mean, most people will advertise. I feel like, though, I'm saying this, like, I feel like I'm gonna be the person that's like, this is my boyfriend, like, check him out.
I want to do that sometimes, but also,
but it's so true. You're trying so hard, like, to build and working so hard to build a brand and an image and like, as your music. And because your Instagram platform and YouTube are, that's like how you're gonna do that, essentially. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah, it does make sense you'd want to keep that private.
Yeah, especially as an independent artist, too. Mm-hmm. Like, a lot of people think, oh, she probably has a marketing person to take care of all this. Like, right now, it's just me doing, yeah, like, my videos, producing music and all of that stuff. So it's just, I don't know, it's, like, sensitive for me. Also, I'm such a hopeless romantic,
yeah,
and I'm open about that. I mean, if you listen to any of my songs, you'll know, like, yeah, wow, she's really always in her feels. I'm always crying, like, every day.
I get you. No.
But...
I'm crying every day. I wish I could do that. I'm trying to channel more of my emotional side and cry.
See, I'll give you some of mine.
Perfect.
I'll give you some of my feelings, and then you can give me some of, the, like, the badass bitchness, you know? Because I need some more of that.
That's me! I know, I'm always like, how do I come across on Instagram? You know what I mean? Like, me and my assistant Sarah were talking about this. Like, she's like, people on my Instagram think I'm just, like, cold, and she's like, but I like it. And I'm like, yeah, it's like your alter ego.
I don't know how people even see me. I honestly don't even know. And I'm trying to get to a point where I just don't care.
Yeah.
But it's so hard. It's so hard because as a female, I've struggled with it so much. Like, it's just easy to get insecure on social media and to worry about what other people think, but it's...
That's what I mean. Like, you just...
It's a lot.
I just can't worry about it anymore. Like, it literally, I've been posting so many, like, serious pics, and I'm like, I like the photos, but I'm like, that's not my personality at all.
Yeah.
But it is awesome.
Yeah.
Me, so I'm just like, whatever. Like, I'll post the weird shit that I do, you know, twerking in Trader Joe's, and then I'll post a serious photo and be like, I'm a boss bitch.
It's so funny because I was just talking about this with my friend yesterday, too. Like, she was saying that I'm a chameleon and I'm a unicorn. She was like, Jules is just, sometimes she looks like the girl next door and sometimes she just looks like this, I just don't, I
spicy
have a
margarita.
Lot of, yeah, a spicy margarita. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's just, I have different sides. We all have different sides to us, you know?
Certain people would just bring out.
Lady in the streets.
Yeah, but every time she eats up.
I didn't say it.
I did.
My goal as an artist is to inspire other people. Right. So hopefully...
You are, girl. You are inspiring the shit out of everybody, okay? Really, you are. Like,
I hope
you are truly, like, just a princess and, like, a presence and a, such a voice and a energy.
That
like
makes
a ball
me so
of, like,
happy.
Love and energy.
That is because I think that's my purpose. I want to spread love and spread light, like, through my music and then just also for my Asian American community. Like, a lot of my fans are Asian American, and it's awesome because, like, it's like I have a family, kind of, but, in mainstream media, like, I think the representation is getting more and more, is getting bigger and bigger, but, it's just growing, so I hope that I can inspire someone out there, and even people who aren't Asian, like,
Well, I'm not Asian, and you inspire me every time, so. No, really, though, you're so great. I'm so thankful for you to come on the show, and...
Thank you for having me.
I love getting to hang. We're seriously gonna go out.
Yes!
I'm making you come out with me.
Yes!
And make you drink.
She's... I'm gonna channel my inner Beyonce.
Yes.
Basically.
Yes, queen!
I'm not a diva!
I'm not a diva!
Hey!
Just like a quick, like...
Yeah, you have to just...
Wait, let's do it together. Let's do it together. Oh, my God. 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes. Okay,
thank
I just
you.
Love you.
Come You're here. Amazing.
Have so much fun in your rehearsal. Bye,
thank
y'all.
You.
Oh, yes, okay, make sure to tune in. My hair is disheveled at this point. No, it's good.
We did a lot of hair flipping.
We did a lot of hair flipping.
A lot of hair flipping.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
You're welcome. Every Tuesday night, 8 p.m., I'll have a new episode for Landed Late Night with some smoking hot guests like her, okay? Okay, and then you have to let everyone know where they can find your music. So where do they go?
Yes, so everything is under Jules Aurora on Spotify, iTunes, Instagram, Facebook, everything.
Yes,
so,
all the things.
Yes, all the things, and then be on the lookout for my new music.
Yes!
This summer!
Yes, and I'm going to link all of her links in the bio of this video,
amazing.
So
thank
y'all
you.
Can find her. I just love you.
Had so much fun.
Yes, Mama. All right, well, I love you guys.
I love
so
you
much.
Too. I love you too.
So, one more hair flip.
Okay.
2, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is, mine's not as cute as hers, but we're
going to... No!